This is Hornstull in southern Stockholm, an area that has gone from being regarded as the outskirts of the city to hipster central with food trucks and street markets. Before the arrival of the food truck, Swedes got their fast food mainly from hot dog stands. Like the Brits who might have a kebab after a night out, the Swedes will head for a hot dog at their local stand, or grill in Swedish. Swedes love their hot dogs, and some even claim they existed here before their invention in Coney Island, New York. In Sweden, however, they use some strange combinations.
I will get a tunnbrödrulle.
Tunnbrödrulle.
With korv, grillad korv.
Grillad korv.
Yeah. And then I'm not sure which topping I should have.
The best one for the tunnbrödrulle, yeah, it's this one, it's shrimp salad.
Okay, shrimp salad. Is that typically Swedish?
Yeah.
And then what's this one here?
That's Boston gurka.
With mayonnaise?
With mayonnaise,
okay.
Yeah.
I actually might go with the mayonnaise.
Mayonnaise?
Yeah, cucumber. Yeah. Cool.
You want any drink?
No, that's great. Thank you very much. Tack så mycket.
For me, a rather unexpected ingredient pairing is to have prawn salad. Prawns and mayonnaise topping a hot dog. Here at this old hot dog stand in Stockholm, they put their own spin on it, using Swedish flatbread, mashed potato, hot dog and a prawn salad.
Wow, that's one hot dog.
There you go.
Tack så mycket.
Enjoy.
Thank you.
Turning a hot dog from a light snack into a meal with all the additional toppings has been done for years in Sweden. Chefs around the world have taken inspiration from street food like hot dogs, transforming them into fine dining versions with the use of luxury ingredients and restaurant cooking techniques.
My smoked sausage potato cakes with prawn salad is inspired by the Swedes' love of hot dog with mashed potatoes and prawns, something rather unusual, but a bit like a Swedish surf and turf. Some hot water on the go. Generous pinch of salt. Peel my potatoes. Add your potatoes to the boiling water and just cook them until they're tender. I've drained my cooked potatoes. I'm going to let them cool down before I use them. I've got some smoked sausage here. I'm going to grate that.
I'm using good quality Frankfurter sausages, which are slightly smoked.
I'm grating the sausage because it means it gets equally distributed through the potato cake. You get that smoky flavour throughout.
And then discard the skins.
Add the sausage to a bowl, some chives, a generous handful.
The chives bring a freshness that cuts through the smoky and rich flavours of the potato cakes. Chives are a popular herb in Swedish cooking.
Chives go in the bowl. Now to bind the potato cakes together, you'll need one egg. Some pepper. Give it a little mix. So once your potatoes are cool enough, you can grate them. Add the potatoes to your bowl and mix everything together. Before I form my patties, I'm going to get a pan nice and hot. Add a little bit of oil, some butter, add a tasty flavour to your potato cakes. And then form your potato mix into four patties. You fry them on one side until you develop like a golden crust, flip it over and fry it on the other side. So you want a lovely golden brown crust. With my potato cakes, I'm gonna have a very simple prawn salad, just with some lemon zest, lemon juice, and a little bit of salt and pepper. Prawns go in. Squeeze in a little lemon juice. You can start off with half and then add a little bit more if you need it. Bit of pepper, pinch of salt, toss that together. It's really just a light, fresh dressing. delicious. Okay, I'm gonna just check here with the potato cakes. So you know when your potato cakes are done, and you've got a nice crust on both sides. You can tap it, feels a bit crunchy. Switch it off, and now you just need to plate it up. So I've got some baby germ lettuce, which I really love. Generous dollop of creme fraiche. It ties everything together, that cool creaminess. Your prawns, a sprig of dill. And then if you want to, if you have a little bit of lemon zest left, you just grate a tiny bit on the top. And that's my Swedish surf and turf.